Hey, it's Dare from Dare Cinema, and in this episode, I'm gonna show you how to use overlays in Premiere Pro to just make your footage look that much better. Hey there, I'm Dare, and Dare Cinema is about sharing the knowledge from living and working in Hollywood and the film industry, and also working for many years in the crazily evolving world of content creation. And really, the new journey that I'm on right now is just 100% independently producing, writing, and directing feature films, while on the side, I do high-end content, you know, commercials for good brands and stuff like that. Now, regardless of the budget of our projects, one thing we all want is better looking footage. And using overlays is a great way to add just some interesting effects to either footage that you've shot in camera or stock footage that you've downloaded, which is more and more common these days. And you know, so much about content creation these days is using every little trick that you can to hold your audience's attention on social media so they don't swipe on to the next thing in 4 seconds or less. And in this episode, I'm gonna show you how to use overlays in Premiere Pro using really the simplest sort of drag and drop method. But then also I'm gonna show you a much more customized approach to just squeeze all the juice out of your overlays, because really one overlay can go a long way. So down below, I've put a link where you can download the free Premiere project and a couple of sample overlays from my Dare Cinema tool bundles that you can use in your own projects. So we're gonna show you how to make this footage already, which is pretty nice, just some downloaded stock footage, which might be common. So this is kind of like your before. And then we're gonna look at using overlays to add just another element of visual interest to help make the shot pop like this. So go ahead and download the project, open the files, and let's get into it. And remember, I always like to include a table of contents in the description below so that you can find what you're looking for fast, because you know, sometimes you just want a specific answer. You know, or of course you could watch this whole video on 2x speed, which will probably prove to be far more amusing. Okay, let's dive into it. Step one is choosing the right overlay. You really need to choose the right overlay, and sometimes between hundreds in your library, and it sort of depends on the mood and style that you want to add to your footage. So take time to select the one that you think fits the most for your project. So once I have that overlay selected, I need to make sure that the timing of the overlay matches our footage, as normally overlays have a specific movement, you know, kind of normal, linear. Sometimes they have fade-ins and fade-outs, and sometimes they don't. So just have that in mind, we just sort of need to time it. All right, let's talk about blending modes. This is the most important step in the overlay process. And blending modes are basically different ways to interpret the way layers of footage blend between each other, using different parameters like luma, saturation, and contrast, as well as just the different color channels of your images. But we're not gonna get into all that technical explanation in this video. That's kind of for a longer term, more in depth. Let's talk about screen mode. Probably the most useful blending mode that you can choose from all of the options available is screen mode. And what does this mode do? Basically, it bypasses the darkest part of your overlay, and most overlays are recorded in a black background. So this is gonna be the best choice most of the time. So once you have the blending mode set, you'll probably end up with something that looks like this. Now that's okay if you like how it looks, but there's always a way to improve how our overlays merge with our footage. Because at the end, we want to make it seamless and try to make our audience think it's in fact part of the scene. Okay, so we're gonna get into adjusting curves. So go ahead and make sure that your Premiere Pro space is laid out like this and you have these monitors on your screen. To start this part, we need to start matching the light levels. And why? Because you don't wanna have your overlay hitting the top of your waveform monitor if your footage is hovering somewhere around the 80s to 90s. By adjusting this correctly, you're gonna have a more impressive overlay that can make the audience think that it's really there as an in-camera effect. Now, we can also use these same curves to get a better contrast for our overlay by adding points at the top and then dragging it up so we can make our overlay brighter. We can also do this the other way. Adding points in the bottom, we can make our overlay less present in the frame as you are reducing the light and the overall effect. And that way, your screen mode has more dark zones to bypass. And remember that over here in the Lumetri color panel, again, which you access from here, window going down to Lumetri color, and it should pop up, that after you've got your curves, you go down to here, this hue versus hue panel. And just by dragging this up or down, you can easily change the color to sort of get it to match
the primary light source in scene so it actually looks like it's there.
So once we have the right kind of tonal configuration for the overlay, we can start making adjustments like, where do we want to place the overlay? Do we want to scale it up or down to make it bigger or smaller? It's all going to depend on the footage that you are using to get it to look right. So here, let's make an example by placing it on the side of the frame and scaling it just a little bit so we can have a smoother effect in the corner. There are a lot of ways to adjust your overlay. For example, you can rotate it in the transform panel, but remember, you also can add a flip effect to have even more configurations possible, putting it up and down or left and right. So to do that, you need to go into the effects browser and type flip, and you'll see two effects, a horizontal flip and a vertical flip. Drag the one that fits the most for your shot onto the overlay, and then you can adjust it. Masking. Now, sometimes you're gonna find that the flare or whatever's in the overlay is occupying too much space in your frame, and that's when applying masks to your overlay can help reduce the presence of it without getting rid of it completely. Again, we're trying to give it a natural look in the frame. So for that, you need to go into this panel and drop down to where it says opacity and choose one of the masks that they have here. Now, normally I start with a circular mask as this can simulate sort of a better natural gradation in the frame. Just place it wherever you think is the best, and then you can go ahead and add feather to sort of smooth the edge of the mask or expand it or all these parameters. You can also animate the mask as your clip advances so you can make the effect appear at a precise moment and you can make it disappear when you need to. Step 6, experiment. Try different overlays, use as many as you can, and try to create the most eye-catching video for your project. Nothing replaces experimenting to really get the hang of this. So just try a bunch of different overlays, use as many as you can, and try to create the most naturalistic but eye-catching sort of shot for your project. These tools have infinite possibilities, and they're gonna help your content have one more layer that people can see without them noticing, but they just look at it and go, wow, that's a much more dynamic, a much more visually interesting frame. So using overlays is just one of the valuable tools that every content creator needs to have in their sort of bag of quick tricks to help make clients happy and to turn out better looking content faster so you can have a more profitable business. So I hope this helped. Please remember to like the channel, subscribe if you want more of this content, and to click for notifications so you get that when it's ready. And also, for those of you who are on Instagram and TikTok, you know, we are creating new videos for there just for like quick tips, quick inspiration. So that should be pretty fun too. And you know, it'd be great if you could just take 15 seconds and in the comments section below, tell me what specifically are the things that you would like to learn about or what would help you in terms of advancing your career. And I'll do tutorials on those. Thanks again for watching, and I hope this was helpful. And if you're looking for something specific, but you just can't find it, leave a comment or send me an email or a message on Instagram or TikTok, and I'll see if I can tackle that for you.